The Night Owl Show, next on Channel 6.
Now, Dr. Timmy, you've stated this afternoon that your delivery of a message from the Palestine Liberation Organization to the Boy Scouts of America was a coincidental incident, and I would like you further to explain that.
Well, there was a Boy Scout within 100, 150 yards from where I was located at that moment, at least it appeared to be a Boy Scout. I took the message and gave it to him.
Now, was it true that Colonel Gaddafi had given it to you personally with the authorization of the present administration and ordered you, in fact, to deliver it to the chief eagle of the Boy Scouts?
I'm not sure if it was the chief eagle. They said there would be an eagle scout. I noticed by his insignia that, at least as I recall, that was the insignia of an eagle scout, and I gave it to him.
And in fact, that man turned out to be an FBI agent by the name of Watbo, right?
Steve Watbo.
Steve Watbo. Now, when you suddenly realized what had happened, what first came to your mind? Did you feel that you'd been set up to be silenced? This has happened before.
What came to mind was that why would I be giving the message to a Boy Scout? How could I have been so foolish? Why would a Boy Scout perhaps be in that location at that time?
Well, in fact, we have the contents of the message, which has just been verified by the FBI in Washington, that says that that in exchange for $300 million, the Boy Scouts of America will fight as a mercenary army for Colonel Gaddafi for the period of 1 year. And that's what you were asked to deliver.
Well, that certainly is something.
And you've no recollection whatsoever of a discussion with Colonel Gaddafi concerning this?
No, I don't.
Would you like to hear the tape recordings that the FBI have of you having that conversation with Colonel Gaddafi? Maybe that would refresh your memory.
I'm very nervous about being here in the first place.
I understand that. Maybe what we could talk about then would be your 1957 conviction for child molestation.
What is the agenda?
The agenda is basically a mind-boggling recitation of the Epic of Man.
Uh-huh.
We thought we would give it in less than 50 minutes.
Well, let's begin.
Okay. And first there was light.
Yes, and then there was?
Darkness.
And then there was?
To complement the light, there was dusk.
Dusk. Mm-hmm. Let's begin with dusk.
Dusk.
What is dusk?
Dusk is a hair split.
Uh-huh.
Splitting hairs. It is neither here nor there, no dark, no light.
Well, if both agencies would agree to incorporate, we wouldn't face those kind of problems.
Well, that's true, the light and dark.
Let's not talk CIA code stuff anymore. Let's talk to the people.
Deep mole digs deeply.
Digs deeply on Tuesdays when the venting system correctly works.
Is that on a side mounted?
I think you've been involved in a little espionage work yourself.
You noticed. Mm-hmm. I've been practicing. I haven't done it in years.
What broadcasting company or newspaper do you work for?
ABC, CBS, and NBC.
All three. Simultaneously work for the CIA?
CIA, FBI, and also the FDA.
Are the networks aware of this? You mean they know, but they don't want to know?
They don't ask more questions than they have to.
Well, let me tell you something.
Yes.
Since you've been so candid with me.
Yes.
I really kind of like you. I don't mind talking at all now.
It's because I'm quite a fellow when you get through this facade.
Yeah, let's give each other the manly hits.
That's quite a punch you got.
Yeah, well.
You used to work out?
Let me tell you.
You were an intelligence man. I can tell by the way you did that. You threw your shoulder into it.
The president of one of the major networks is, in fact, working for Peruvian interests, has been for the last 10 years.
We're fully aware of that.
And receives burlap bags
daily
of $100 bills.
I know, daily.
Daily.
I know. We have him photographed and we have him dead to rights, but what we're going for is Mr. Big.
Mr. Big?
We're going for the Big Kahuna.
The Big Kahuna.
That's the code word we've assigned to this whole project is Kahuna.
Uh-huh.
Kahuna 1 and Kahuna 2.
Kahuna 1? Knock, knock.
I don't think we should be on this subject.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Kahuna.
Kahuna. Kahuna who?
Kahuna 1 or 2?
Kahuna 2.
Mm-hmm.
You were an operative?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Anyway, the CIA has known for a long time that all of the major networks in the United States were controlled basically by one person,
mm-hmm.
not living in the continental United mm-hmm. States.
John Laval.
Let me say his code name, and I can give you his Spanish code name.
Johnny
Juan, mm. Juan Lavalle.
Mm-hmm. Well, unless you're adept at languages, you'll never figure that
one
out.
Well, that's the main thing.
That's a very clever method of disguise.
What he did is he hid out in upstate New York for many years.
Mm-hmm.
And we've seen it on tape, time and time again. He's here.
Some kind of seeping noise.
It's gas.
Guess what?
It's all over.
I'm putting my mask on. Bye-bye, Robert.
Mine's off.
I wasn't there.
Well, the fingerprints seem to be yours.
I really don't understand this type of harassment.
It's not really harassment. Sir, I was just given your standard biographical information by the State Department. And in it, it included that you, in fact, had been divorced 3 times.
May I speak frankly to
once
you?
Once for impotence.
Apparently, I am to be
sexual
on this
aggravation,
program.
And once for
I'm
sorry.
Receive some kind of leniency in sentencing if I supposedly tell the American people or whoever this is going to about some of the activities I was involved in, but of course. This government wants me to tell only selected activities because I've been involved in all kinds of operations for all kinds of people.
Over a number of years in the United States?
No.
Were these foreign operations?
No.
Were they the jurisdiction of the CIA?
No.
Were you, in fact, at the Bay of Pigs in 1950?
No.
On a preliminary raid?
Nope.
I have photographs of you.
Well,
let me say
that the
dressed in full
that one of the topics
regalia.
Was very warm.
One of the topics was very warm.
One of the
and
locations you mentioned was warm.
Okay, and did it in fact, was it South America?
Warmer.
I haven't done this since grammar school. Has it been Chile?
Really warm.
Argentina?
Hot, hot.
Honduras?
Red hot, red hot.
Tierra del Fuego?
The Night Owl Show, Fridays at midnight on Channel 6.
Whoa, say,
Channel 6 concludes its programming day with our national anthem.
By the dawn's early light,
what so proudly we hailed.
What so proudly we hailed.
With the twilight's last gleaming.
At the twilight's last gleaming.
And the rocket's red glare.
The bombs bursting in air. It gave proof through the night. We all had such a fright. But when we awoke, it was still there.
say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land? Whoa, of a free and the home of the brave.